Hello students, welcome again to our chemistry video session lesson class. In the last video class we have done up to the crystalline form of carbon of chapter number 9, carbon and its compound. So by continuing this chapter today, I will start from the amorphous form of carbon. As you know, the carbon is formed in two forms, that is crystalline form and amorphous form, that is non-crystalline form. So in amorphous crystalline form, we have seen there are three types of crystalline form of carbon, that is diamond, graphite and fullerenes. We have seen their properties, physical properties. On the basis of the physical properties, we have also seen their uses. Okay. So now, today we will do the amorphous form of carbon. Amorphous form of carbon means the non-crystalline form of carbon actually. So this amorphous means which have no definite shapes or forms. Like example, charcoal, coal, lamp black, gas, carbon and coke. So one by one we will see the non-amorphous form of carbon. First is charcoal. As you know that charcoal is a black, soft and porous solid. But how this charcoal is made? Charcoal is made by heating coal or wood in the absence of air. It is strongly heated. When we strongly heat coal or wood in the absence of air, we will get charcoal. Okay. And the process of this heating in the absence of air is called destructive distillation. What we call it is? The word is destructive distillation. Okay. What is this destructive distillation? Strongly heating in absence of air. In absence, strongly heating in the absence of air is called destructive distillation. So by destructive distillation of coal or wood, you will get the charcoal. So as a result, destructive distillation substance decomposes into its constituent substances. Okay. So one example is also given in your activities given, the destructive distillation of wood. Some wood pieces have been kept on a test tube which is strongly heated in the absence of air. So in the absence of air, when it is heated, a gas comes out. When this gas is collected in another test tube which contains proligenous acid, what you will see, some black color, some deposits forms at the bottom of the test tube, that is called the wood tar. And if it is a coal, then it is called coal tar also. So by this process, we can, and the residue that left over the test tube which was being heated in hot glass test tube, that is the charcoal, that is called charcoal. Okay. So by the destructive distillation of wood, you will get wood charcoal, pyrogelinous acid, wood tar and wood gas. Okay. So in the like manner, the destructive distillation of sugar can be done also, and bones gives sugar charcoal, bones gives bone charcoal as a residue. When charcoal is heated further, it forms a activated charcoal. When charcoal is strongly heated further, it is called activated charcoal. Activated charcoal is more porous than a charcoal. Activated charcoal, when charcoal is heated when charcoal is strongly heated, it is strongly heated, it gives activated charcoal. Okay, it gives activated charcoal. So on the basis this charcoal, we have so many uses in our daily life. One by one we will see that charcoal is porous, means it absorbs water and it allows some water to pass through it. It is used as a good adsorbent to absorb gases and colors. So charcoal is a good adsorbent which absorb gases and color. It is used in a gas mask for industrial and military purposes, and as a decolorizing agent also. Activated charcoal is used as an adsorbent in household water filters. It is replaced by use of charcoal, as it is a better adsorbent, means it absorbs the impurities present in the water and it allows clean water to pass through them. So it is also used as a deodorizing agent for removal of foul smell. The residue wood charcoal obtained after a destructive distillation of wood is used for the domestic fuel also. It has a high carbon content and it has a better fuel than a normal wood, and also gives less smoke. So this is the charcoal, about charcoal. Next is the coal is another form of amorphous form of carbon. Coal is black, hard, solid. It is formed by the process of coalification. Coalification is involved the conversion of wood or decaying vegetable matters into coal under high pressure and high temperature. So when dead matters of plants or woods get deposited deep inside the earth due to the high pressure of the earth and the high temperature of the earth, slowly these woods converted into carbon, that is called carbonification. After the carbonification, slowly this carbon become hard and forms a coal. So it takes millions of years to form coal from the decaying vegetable matters. So mainly the coal has four types of coal. First is called lignite, then bituminous, then anthracite, and last three types of coal are given in your book: lignite, bituminous and anthracite. And one more coal is there, that is called pit coal. It is now not given in your book. That is called pit coal. It is actually lignite is also a form of pit coal. It contains carbon content is only 60 to 70%. It contains only 60 to 70% carbon. It contains, okay. So it is very low quality of carbon. Then it's a bituminous. It contains about 70 to 90% carbon. It contains about more 70 to 90% carbon. Okay, and it is called bituminous or medium quality of coal. Its bituminous coal is also known as household coal because it is also used by in so many villages and so many areas for cooking purposes. Okay, in chulhas, you know. Then anthracite is another coal. Is a very hard coal. Its carbon content is about 92 to 98%. Its carbon content is about 92% to 98% carbon content. It is best quality of coal. once it is ignited, it burns for a long time to give lots of energy also. Okay. It gives lots of energy. So pit coal, first form is pit coal. The better quality of pit coal is lignite. After that lignite, it is bituminous coal, and after bituminous it is excuse me students, sorry for the interruption. Next is I'm talking about the types of coal. The pit coal, the next better quality of pit coal is lignite, after that is bituminous, and then anthracite is the best quality of coal. Now the coal, uses of coal, there is a different uses of coal. You know, it is used as a fuel in industrial purposes, in domestic purposes also. It is used to prepare coke, coal gas and coal tar. By the destructive distillation of coal, we get these things. It is the source of organic compounds such as benzene and naphthalene also. It is used in the manufacture of synthetic coal, perfumes, drugs, textiles and fertilizers. Okay. So, these are that about the charcoal and coal. There are another types of amorphous, that is next one is lamp black, that is also called soot. Lamp black or soot. Next is the lamp black. What is lamp black? Lamp black. Lamp black is another form, another amorphous form of carbon. It is very fine powder, black powder. It is prepared by burning of hydrocarbon as kerosene, oil, wax, petrol, naphthalene in a limited supply of air. Lamp black is used as a pigment of manufacturing in shoe polishes, black paints and colors. It also used in printing of cartridges of printing or printers, you can say. So, because it leaves black mark on the paper, so it is having used so many uses. Next, after lamp black, then is called lamp black is also in Hindi or Bengali we call it the kajal. You can say lamp black is also called as soot or kajal. It is also called as kajal that we put in our eyes. Next is the gas carbon. Next one is the gas carbon. So the gas, what is this gas carbon? Gas carbon is a black powder, again it is, that gets deposited on heating of hydrocarbon in the absence of air. During the destructive distillation of coal, you will get the gas carbon. It is also having so many uses. It is a good conductor of electricity, so it is used in the manufacturing of electrode. It is used in the manufacturing of electrodes. Remember this. Next, the last form of amorphous form of carbon that is given in your book, that is the coke. Coke is a dark black solid obtained as a residue during again destructive distillation of coal. Coke is also used as a fuel in industries, and it does not produce smoke on burning. It acts as a good reducing agent again. It is used in the manufacturing of gaseous fuels like water gas and producer gas. Water gas, what is water gas? Water gas is a mixture of carbon monoxide and hydrogen. And producer gas is a mixture of carbon monoxide and nitrogen. What is water gas? What is water gas? Water gas is a mixture of carbon monoxide plus hydrogen. And next is producer gas. Producer gas, it is a mixture of carbon monoxide and nitrogen. Okay, carbon dioxide, nitrogen gas. All this mixture when passed over the red hot coke. Okay, Students, so these are the amorphous form of carbon that we have discussed in today's video lesson. I hope you have understood these things, what I have taught you. Please read it from your book also and try to get the answers. After your exam, we will do some question answers from this portion also. And the next video's class, I will start from carbon dioxide. Okay, students? Thank you very much for watching this video. And please try to give your today's exam nicely. I hope you have already prepared for your exam. Best of luck to all of you for today's exam and obviously for the next exams. Okay, students, thank you very much.